Ask anyone under 30 if he can remember a time when Walt Disney wasn't on television. Bet she can. Because the Disney show has been on for more than a quarter of a century. The all-time record. That's a lot of Sunday nights. Walt's show got the lion's share of the ratings. He was the first major motion picture producer to fall for television. He discovered that entertainment and education could be successfully combined, as long as the emphasis remained on entertainment. Walt had already made stars of animated animals. Now he would do the same for their real-life counterparts. Always the storyteller, he was able to capture the drama and the tension of the struggle for survival. But occasionally, Walt couldn't help playing it for comedy. Walt's success with the true-life adventures of animals led him to the almost true-life adventures of humans.
Davy, Davy Crockett, king of the wild frontier.
That's right. Davy burst upon the scene with incredible impact. Almost overnight, kids were wearing Davy Crockett coonskin caps, toting Davy Crockett toy rifles, eating Davy Crockett cookies, listening to Davy Crockett records, reading Davy Crockett books, playing Davy Crockett games. When they got tired, falling asleep between Davy Crockett's sheets. But for all the merchandise that Davy sold, it was only a drop in a Texas bucket compared to the merchandise sold by the all-time champion.
Thank you.
Now, some people get big, brassy ticker tape parades down Broadway, and that's pretty heady stuff. But what might even be nicer in a quieter way is having the folks in your hometown turn out to tell you they're proud of you and to say to you, nice going. Well, that's just what the folks in Marceline did for Walt and Roy back in 1956. A couple of hometown boys who made good.
In love.